Hi folks, this is Mario Pitch with the 12th video about the TeleWiki development environment how-to. Yeah, this is a little bit unexpected because I wanted to show you how to connect to Bears Bears repository, and there is a patch where he submitted screenshots, so I thought it should be okay. But there actually seems to be a little bug, which is really funny, because it allows me to create a pull request to be Bears pull request. So this is really nice because it shows a completely different workflow. Yeah, with the videos I did already, the workflow created pull requests directly against the core plugin. But now, which is also possible, we can create a pull request against any fork. Yeah? And then if Tobias accepts the pull request, it will be part of his pull request against the core. So yeah, let's have a look at this workflow. It's very, very interesting. So yeah, we did go to TobiBears repository. We added the link to our local repository. Yeah? So now TobiBear is part of our local repo. Then I did check out TobiBears patch 13, and I did build it. Okay, then I did load it, reload, and boom, it didn't work because he forgot to assign the max width to the first elements. So there are the thumbnails, yeah, which is this div. Yeah. So if I say right mouse click inspect, I can see that the wrapper of those buttons has the max width 800. Yeah, but the wrapper, which one is it? This wrapper here. Oops, sorry. Right mouse click inspect. This wrapper has no max width. Yeah, can you see it here? Yeah. So it seems he forgot to copy it over again. I just take the same settings, so everything should look in the same way. It's like this. Say okay and test it. Yeah, as you can see now, it looks like as expected, and also as the screenshot shows. Yeah? So if we go back to the pull request, back. Yeah, so this should be the expected behavior. Yeah? Okay, now let's search. There is hello there. Then I can say I want to highlight as HTML, which is not really 100% okay because it is wiki text, but anyway. So I get a little bit of highlighting, which is the style here. Control C, Control V. Now I changed it. I save it. It says that there is some modifications. Then I build it again. Boom, it's built. And then I reload it again. If the page. Okay, now it looks like the expected behavior. What do we have to do? We create a new branch from this one. And we call it to be here patch 13. Okay, now Let's commit it. Maybe an oversight. Didn't work out. Okay. Now we push our patch to TLV. Okay. And we create a new pull request. So here it says Toby Bear patch 13, compare and pull request. Okay, then it shows us what we changed. Yeah. Okay, add to be us. Okay, so I created a pull request against Toby Pears patch. Why did it go? No, it did go to Jeremy Master. No, I wanted to. Anyway, no problem. So we will follow this one. Yeah, I will create a link to the video, and then we will see what happens. Yeah? So there are two commits, one file changed. Yeah, we will see. Very interesting, and we'll see how this goes on. Yeah, have fun with the next videos. Which will cover a little bit of the command line magic. Yeah, see you.